In this video, we'll be talking about chaos engineering for Kubernetes, and we'll be discussing a tool called Litmus. So chaos engineering is nothing but creating chaos inside your Kubernetes cluster, like deleting the pod, killing the container, hopping up the networks, and trying to find out the issues before they actually occur in production. So say that you have a CI/CD pipeline, and that pipeline, you have some chaos experiments, and if they fail, you get the reason and you get to know where exactly which particular aspect of your Kubernetes cluster fails. So this helps, in getting to know the actual issues before they occur in the production scenario. So it makes your Kubernetes cluster more resilient and more reliable for the end users. Now, what we can do is, I already have a Civo cluster created. So, and there is a Litmus Chaos app. So I've already installed the application. So Litmus Chaos apps is a marketplace apps inside Civo that I can install with one click. I've already installed that, and let's just check it. Kubectl get pods hyphen n litmus. You should be seeing an operator over here. Yes, so the chaos operator is running. Now what we'll do is, let's go through some of the concepts real quick. So chaos engineering, taking the cloud native approach, and it has few CRDs like the chaos engine, chaos experiment, and chaos result. So a chaos engine basically is a resource that is linked to a Kubernetes application or a Kubernetes node to a chaos experiment, and it is watched by the chaos operator that will in turn invoke the experiment. So you can see, so this experiment comes here and it will invoke the experiment. Now comes the chaos experiment, which actually is created by the operator, and the chaos engine will run it. So chaos runner is responsible for running that particular experiment, that particular scenario that you have defined in the CRD. Next will be the chaos results, which tell you whether the experiment was successful or it has failed. There's one more thing that I want to highlight is the Litmus Chaos Hub. So it is hub.litmuschaos.io, which is a full hub station for chaos experiments. It has a list of all the experiments which are existing that you can readily install, and it has generic experiments which we'll be using today, and out of that we'll be using a pod delete one and the pod auto scale one. There are other one like node drain, container kill, disk fill. I think all these are very important, and that's why they are, you know, they are already inside the generic ones. So let's start by first creating the names, creating the namespace and the service account. So a simple service account with few verbs. Let's create that. Kubectl create hyphen f service account. I already have the service account YAML file. So it creates the namespace, the service account, chaos SA, and the role binding. Next is that we should be installing some of the experiments. So what we'll do is, I already have a list of the generic experiments. So kubectl apply hyphen f experiments, and let's install in demo namespace. What it will do is, it will install all the experiments for like pod network duplication, all the generic experiments that are there, and from this we'll be using the autoscaler one, and we'll be using the pod delete one. Let's clear out the screen, and we can see that chaos experiments are there. Perfect. And now let's create a Nginx deployment with two replicas. So this is just an imperative way of creating a deployment inside a Kubernetes cluster. Kubectl create deployment, Nginx image also is Nginx, then replicas, namespace, because there is all the chaos experiments that are there. And just delete this portion. Deployment is created. So let's go back, and now is the time that we create chaos engine. So vi chaos engine, I already have it, let me just check. So cat l pod delete, yes. So basically what it is doing is, we are just specifying that the namespace is demo, the label, deployment, annotation check is false. If it's true, then we have to annotate that. So if it's true, you need to annotate the deployment with this particular command to make this work. Else, let's keep it false for this particular example and the chaos service account that we just created. Then the experiment. So experiment is pod delete, and the spec section we have actually defined the components, like the total chaos duration will be 30, interval will be 10, and the force value will be false. These are just the random values, the values which are defined in the experiment. So that can be seen from the docs as well. So let's apply this kubectl apply hyphen f l pod delete. So our experiment is created. Now let's see the pods. We should be seeing the chaos runner getting created. And now the chaos runner is running and the pod delete experiment is running. It's in container creating. Pulling the image, most probably we can describe, but let's try pod hyphen n demo. Yeah, it's still pulling the image, the runner image. And you can see one of the pod is terminating already. So one of the Nginx pod is already terminating, and obviously the another one will start because it's a deployment. So what we'll do is we can actually see the results. So let's describe the chaos result. I have to just remove. Result is still awaited. Let it just populate. And the result is pass. So the result has been populated because the pod was deleted, and you can see the result as pass. So this was a pod delete experiment. Now let's move on to the pod autoscale experiment. It is kind of the similar one. You have demo namespace, app Nginx, deployment as the same service account, and you have the experiment pod autoscaler. So we specify the chaos duration and we also specify the replica count. So this is the main value, the replica that we want to scale. And let's apply that file. I already have that file. Let's create it. Create or apply hyphen f l auto scale, I believe. Yes. So this is configured to use now the autoscaler kubectl get pods hyphen n demo, and again now the pod autoscaler is getting pulled. It's running, and now we should be able to see the containers creating, and we can see the 10 replicas will be created. And after they are created, we will be seeing, we can also see the result. So let's describe the result again that we did previously as well. So let's describe this. Still awaited. I think it will populate after 60 seconds. Oh, okay, it's already there. So it was just syncing up. So the result is pass and the pod autoscaler is also completed. So in this way, there can be different chaos experiments, and you can see the chaos experiment name, the status and the events that happened. So you can go and you know, play around with all the other experiments that are there, the generic ones or the specific ones for specific scenarios, or you can create one and contribute to one of the experiments. So that's it for this lecture. Thank you for watching.